हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आज हम करने जा रहे हैं क्लास 8 का नया चैप्टर शुरू, जिसका नाम है कोल एंड पेट्रोलियम। लेट्स स्टडी अबाउट द कोल एंड पेट्रोलियम। इन टुडेज लेसन वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द कोल ओनली। इन अदर टाइप लेसन वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द पेट्रोलियम। फर्स्ट कम टू द कोल। बिफोर डिस्कसिंग कोल स्टूडेंट्स, लेट्स फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल अंडरस्टैंड द टर्म रिसोर्सेज। व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय द टर्म रिसोर्सेज? Resources are the things or the materials which are used by the human beings or which are needed by the man, human beings. These are known as all resources. For example, if I am using a mobile phone, if I am using a marker, these all are what? Resources for me. Now, resources can be obtained from the natural sources. Resources obtained from the natural sources are called natural resources. For example, air, water, soil, coal, petroleum, they all are what? Natural resources. So here we will be discussing about the natural resources. See students, natural resources are again divided into two categories. First is renewable resources and other one is non-renewable resources. Let's study what is renewable resources and what is a non-renewable resources. As I always say is that the name itself explains it. For example, renewable, what does it mean? Let's break the word. Renew plus able. Renew means what? The things which can be renewed, दोबारा बना सकते हैं जिनको, and able, ability. Those resources which can be renewed in a very short period of time, that are known as what? Renewable resources. Resources which can be renewed in a short period of time. Resources which can be renewed in a short period of time are called renewable resources. Short period of time are called renewable resources. Then what is non-renewable? The resources which cannot be renewed in a short period of time or which requires thousands of years to get renewed. The resources which cannot be renewed in a short period of time are called non-renewable resources. Secondly, if renewable resources are renewed, means they are generating again and we are generating them again and again in a very short period of time, it means they will not end up. They are inexhaustible. वो कभी खत्म नहीं होंगे. So the renewable resources are inexhaustible. They will never end up. Inexhaustible. And the non-renewable resources will end up after a period of time. So they are considered as inexhaustible resources. They are what? Exhaustible resources. They will end up after a period of time. Now, coming to the examples. What are the examples of renewable resource? See students, we all know that solar energy can never be, and water, air, these are the some sources which can never be end. So these all comes under the category of renewable resources. Solar, water, air, more we will write, more proper word would be wind. And non-renewable will be coal, petroleum, or collectively we can call them fossil fuels. Coal, petroleum, or we can write fossil fuels. Fossil fuels. So this was all about the renewable and non-renewable resources. Now coming to the next topic, which is fossil fuel. Before studying these fossil fuel, let's discuss the meaning of the term fossil. What does fossil stands for? Fossils are the dead remains of plants and animals which are buried deep inside the earth. These are known as what? Fossils. What are fossils? The dead remains of plants and animals. The dead remains of plants and animals. Plants and animals buried under the earth. Buried under the earth are called fossils. So now what are fossil fuels? When we start utilizing fossils as a fuel, they are known as fossil fuels. Now what are fossil fuels? We had seen some examples of fossil fuel, coal and petroleum. These are the common examples of fossil fuel. So how does a coal form? Coming to the coal. What is coal and how does it form? Coal is a fossil fuel, earliest used fossil fuel. Coal ko hum bahut 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 purane time se use karte hain as a fuel, and it is the earliest used fossil fuel. Coal contains carbon, hydrogen, oxygen and some amount of nitrogen also. Coal is formed by the process of carbonization. Coal is formed by the process of carbonization. Now what is carbonization? See, when the vegetation or of a particular area buried down due to some natural calamity, say earthquake, floods, volcano eruption or something like this, when the vegetation of a particular area, including the animals or the human beings also, get buried inside the earth, and as it goes down, the temperature increases as well as the pressure also increases, and the organic components of the animals and plants converted into the fossils, and they are used as a fossil fuel. So this becomes the coal, and the whole process is known as what? Carbonization. So the carbonization is the process of formation of coal. See students, there are four types of coal: peat, lignite, bituminous and anthracite. These four are the types of coal. Among these four, the best quality coal is anthracite because it contains about 94% to 98% carbon. So it produces it burns with a very little smoke. And the poorest quality of coal is peat. Peat contains very less amount of carbon, approximately 30%. So it is the poorest quality of carbon. It produces a lot of smoke, and anthracite produces a very little smoke when it is burned. So now we will study about the destructive distillation of coal. Now what is destructive distillation? When coal is burned in the absence of air, the process is called destructive distillation. Can anything be burned in the absence of air? No, we cannot burn anything in the absence of air. So why I am saying that when coal is burned in the absence of air, it means the sufficient amount of air is not given to it. Only the required amount of air is given for the burning process. This is known as what? Destructive distillation. Destructive distillation. When the coal is burned in the absence of air, the process is called destructive distillation. The burning of coal in the absence of air. The burning of coal in the absence of air is called destructive in the absence of air is called destructive distillation. Okay. After destructive distillation, we get a number of products like coke, coal tar, coal gas, will be discussing these three products of the destructive distillation of coal. Let's study. First product of destructive distillation is coke. What is coke? It is not the coke which you guys drink. It is, the spelling is same only, coke. But it is the toughest and the purest form of carbon. It is a tough, porous and black substance. It is a tough, porous and black substance. Or we can say it is the purest form of carbon. The formula of coke is C. What is the formula of coke? C. It is the purest form of carbon. It is the purest form of carbon. Coke is used mainly in the extraction of metals. When metals are extracted from their ores like copper, iron, in that extraction process, coke is used at many places, at a permanent, at a particular place. So coke is used in the extraction of metal. Coke is used in the extraction of metals. Coke is used in the extraction of metals. Okay. Along with this, coke is also used in production of some fuel gases like producer gas and water gas. You have to remember the formula of producer and water gas. What is producer gas and what is water gas? Coke is also used in the production of producer gas. Now what is producer gas? It contains carbon monoxide. CO stands for carbon monoxide. Mono means one. Oxide means oxygen. Carbon monoxide. When we write CO2, carbon dioxide. Di means two and O2 stands for oxide. Okay, here. Carbon monoxide plus nitrogen. So what is the formula of producer gas? Carbon monoxide plus nitrogen. Other one is water gas. Water gas. What is water gas? It is again carbon monoxide plus hydrogen. So coke is used in the production of producer gas and water gas. Producer gas is, student, CO plus N2 or carbon monoxide plus nitrogen, and water gas is carbon monoxide plus hydrogen. These two gases are known as fuel gases. These two gases can be used as a fuel also. So this was all about the coke. Now the second product is coal tar. Let's study about the coal tar. Coal tar is a black liquid. Coal tar is a black liquid produced by the destructive distillation of coal. And there are a number of uses of coal tar. Coal tar is used in the preparation of naphthalene balls. Naphthalene balls. In the preparation of explosives, many drugs, and also in the preparation of perfumes. Coal tar is also used in the preparation of perfumes. So you have to remember the uses of coal tar. Okay. Next is coal gas. Now what is coal gas? Coal gas is a mixture of coal gas, it is a mixture of carbon monoxide plus methane. Methane, the formula of methane is CH4. It is methane and hydrogen. And hydrogen. It is the formula of coal gas. Coal gas was earlier used in cooking and lightning. Pehle kaam mein liya jata tha. Cooking or lightning purpose ke liye, but nowadays it is not in much use. So it was all about the coal. Today, in today's lesson, we had discussed about the coal, destructive distillation of coal, and the products formed by the destructive distillation of coal like coke, coal tar and coal gas. In our next lesson, we will be discussing about the petroleum.